You know just where to wank, Thomas, laughed his driver. You could almost manage it without me. Thomas had become conceited. He didn't realize his driver was
f***ing cunt.
I'd never wank without my driver, said Toby earnestly. I'd be frightened. Huh, boasted Thomas. I'm not scared.
You'd never dare.
I would then.
You'd never dare.
I would then.
You'd never.
I would.
You'd never.
I would.
You'd never.
I would. The next morning, the firelighter came.
All over.
Thomas's
face.
Thomas thought he was being clever. Really, he was only moving because a careless cunt had meddled with his controls.
He tried to come,
but he couldn't. He just kept rolling, 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 rolling.
Keep rolling, 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 rolling. Keep rolling, 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 rolling.
There was the station master's house. The station master was about to have sex.
No!
Cried Thomas and shut his eyes. Semen was everywhere. Thomas had tucked a bush on his travels. He couldn't speak. The station master was fucking furious.
You cunt,
his wife scolded. Just look what you've done to Bob Breakfast.
Then the Scottish twin engines, Donald and Douglas and Douglas and Donald and Douglas and Douglas and Donald arrived.
Dinner, f*** yourself, Thomas. We'll rip you.
It's too fucking mute. I'd be wanting, Thomas.
Whoosh! Bits of fencing and a broken window frame festooned his bush, which was badly twisted. The twins wanked and left him. There was worse to come.
You're in a lot of s***.
I know, sir. I'm sorry, sir.
Thomas's voice was muffled behind his bush. You must go to the works and have your dick mended.
Yes, sir.
Meanwhile, a diesel rail car will do your work.
Diesel, sir?
Thomas spluttered. Diesels always stay in their sheds till they are fucking. Diesels never take station masters from behind.